that's Romans 11, verses 33 and 36. When we get there, can we have a hearty amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Romans 11, Romans chapter 11, verses 33 and 36 reads, "Oh, the depth of the riches and wisdom and knowledge of God. How unsearchable are his judgments and how inscrutable his ways. For who has known the mind of the Lord? Or who has been his counselor? Or who has given a gift to him that might be repaid? For him and through him and to him are all things. To him be the glory forever. Amen."
Amen.
Amen.
Father God, we come today to pay homage to you.
Yeah.
We thank you for all your love and your blessings you have shown us.
Yeah.
Just from the waking of this morning and giving us breath.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord. From the clothes that we wear.
Yeah.
Y'all look so nice in the congregation. It's all for me, Father God.
Yeah, thank you.
From every morsel of food that we consume, we give you all the glory.
Yeah.
Father God, in these times, I just pray that everyone has a fear-shaking life.
Yeah.
All your people, just to have the things that I just prayed for. Father God, continue to watch over us.
Yeah.
We know you are one true and only God, the Alpha, the Omega.
Yeah.
The King's a King, the Lord of Lords.
Yeah.
Watch over us and guide us through this service, Father God. We are happy to be in your presence.
Yeah.
In Jesus' heavenly name, we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
All right. This morning, we're going to start with our opening hymn and your bulletin. And it's titled, "I Must Tell Jesus."
Amen.
Amen.
I must tell Jesus all of my trials.
I cannot.
on church.
Amen.
Sister Bernadette, good to see you again.
Amen.
Latoya, welcome.
Amen.
Sister Linda Glover, I know she's in the house, she was on vacation last week. We're glad to have her back.
Yeah.
We love her.
Yeah.
Brother Troy, good to see you.
Amen.
Sister Jessica.
Amen.
How's your work look?
Much better.
Amen. Good to see you, my sister. As we continue in the spirit of the Lord, we are going to participate in our responsive reading entitled Love.
Amen.
I will read the light, and the congregation will respond in the dark. Our responsive reading comes from 1 Corinthians, verse 13, and it reads, though I speak with the tongue of men and of angels and have not charity, I am become as sound as brass or a tinkling cymbal.
And though I have the gift of prophecy, and I understand all mystery, and all knowledge, and though I have all faith, so that I can move mountains, and have my charity, I am nothing.
And though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, and through me, though I give my body to be burned and have no charity, it profits me nothing.
Charity suffers long and is kind. Charity endeth not. Charity wanteth not itself, is not puffed up.
Though not we have itself unseemly, seeketh not her own, is not easily provoked, thinketh no evil.
Rejoiceth not in iniquity, but rejoiceth in truth.
Beareth all things, believeth all things, hopeth all things, endureth all things.
Charity never fails, but whether there be prophecies, they shall fall. Whether there be tongues, they shall cease. Whether there be knowledge, they shall vanish away.
For we know in part, and we prophesy in part.
But when that which is perfect comes, then that which is dark shall be done away.
When I was a child, I spake as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things.
For now we see through a glass darkly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then shall I know, even though I told them I am known.
All together now.
And now abides faith, hope, charity, these three. But the greatest of these is charity.
Amen. All right. Very good, congregation.
All right.
Lord. Yes, Lord.
He's watched over me when I didn't even know he
was. Yes,
yes. Amen. So I thank you for that.
Amen.
Thank you, God.
All right. All right. Now we're going to praise and worship some more.
Amen.
Like that beautiful choir up there. Sing us a selection.
Yes.
I'm available to you.
That was beautiful, ladies. That was beautiful.
That was.
As we continue in the spirit of the Lord.
Yes.
We are going to call on our very own Deaconess Debbie Burst.
Yeah.
She can come up and give us our announcements and our recognition of visitors.
Amen.
Please and thank you.
Thank you.
And amen.
Yes, Lord. Yeah. Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Deacon Harris. Good morning, Pastor. Good morning, Reverend Hall. Good morning, saints.
Good morning.
At this time, I would like to welcome our visitor. If you are in the congregation and would like to stand, we would like to welcome you. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
Your name, sir? Well, we want you to know, Mr. Jackson, that you did not have to stand, but we are thankful that you did. We hope that there is a prayer, a word, a song, or something that was said today that will bring you right back here again next time.
Yeah. Amen.
And happy Father's Day.
God be with you.
And saints, now our announcements for Sunday, June 19th. Coronavirus, wear your mask, and please practice social distancing, 6 feet distance at all times. North Park, Saturday, June 25th. Time to be announced. She is on the back table. Ministry of Comfort, third quarter donations for this term. The deacon and deaconess meeting is monthly, the second Friday at 3 p.m. Fellowship dinner is July 10th. We will go out to eat. Chat and chew as a church family. Restaurant is Bravo's in North Hills at 2 p.m. July 10th, dinner will be after morning service worship. Sheep on the back table. Missionary luncheon, Saturday, July 23rd at 12.
Amen.
Missionary outreach, that's our evangelism, is August 13th.
Amen.
All missionaries are requested to be there.
Amen.
Idlewild Park, Saturday, August 20th. The sheet is on the back table. Roundup is September 17th. And again, the sheet is on the back table. Right. Happy birthday to the June Saints. Mikey Thomas is the first. Sister Linda Glover is the 10th. And Reverend Michael Payne is the 27th.
Amen.
Lord, thy loved one is sick. Brother Michael Beasley is at home. Brother Wayne Stevens is at Skyview. Reverend Earl Russell is at home. And Charles Williams is at home.
Amen.
Pray for Mr. and Mrs. Wilbur, who is also at home. And I always say, saints, pray for the caregivers.
Yes.
Amen. That concludes all I have. Thank you.
Amen. I'll say yes, Lord, yes, to your will and to your way. I say yes, Lord, yes, I will serve you and obey. When your spirit speaks to me, with my whole heart I'll agree, and my answer will be yes, Lord, yes, Lord. I'll say yes, Lord, yes, to your will and to your way. I'll say yes, Lord, yes, I will serve you and obey. When your spirit speaks to me, with my whole heart I'll agree, and my answer Lord, yes. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Praise
God. Happy Father's Day.
Happy Father's Day.
Amen.
Happy Father's Day. Where's Justin? Come on down here for a second.
All right.
Come on down, Justin. Get ready to get into our prayer. Boy, boy, you're big, man. Woo, you're like a linebacker. What's up, man? Go over here and get those bags. The first from your right, get the four from your right. Right there. Yeah, those four. Get four of them. Get four of them. Amen. And get one more. Get one more for a visitor. Get one more for a visitor. Amen. This is Father's Day. Amen. Praise the Lord. Father's Day. Amen. All right, seven right there, Justin. All right, we have little gifts for the fathers. Justin, wait a minute. Okay, this is, get us to that brother in the red shirt. Amen. Neve, come on, Neve. Come on down here, Neve.
Donnie's not a visitor.
This is for Father's Day. Neve, get us to your pap.
That's Pawpaw.
Pawpaw, to your Pawpaw. Justin, get us to Brother Porter. You know who Brother Porter is? Brother Porter's right over there, behind that pole. Amen. This is for Reverend Payne. Reverend Payne. The Vader should be one over there for
right here.
Troy. For Troy Noah. Should be one over there for Troy Noah. Amen. Troy sitting back there in the back. Amen. For Troy Noah. Amen. Happy Father's Day, fathers.
Amen.
Isn't it good to be in the house of the Lord one more time?
Yes.
Praise God, from whom all blessings flow.
Yes.
Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen. Some quick announcements. The sign-up sheets are back there in the back. Please look for the sign-up sheets. BB and Tori, we want you all to come to our picnic on the 25th?
Next Saturday.
This Saturday coming up?
Yes.
Okay, this Saturday coming up. Amen. This Saturday. So if you haven't signed the sign-up sheet, please sign the sign-up sheet. Amen. Is there a grill out there? Pardon me?
I'll address it afterwards. I can get up.
Oh.
Can I say, if you have a shelter, there's this grill that's cemented down into the ground. There's grills there.
Okay. Amen. Amen.
Thank you,
Jeff. Ottawa Park is coming up. Roundup. Missionary Day. Please be advised of those announcements. Listen, we didn't sing happy birthday to the June birthday participants this year. Whose birthday is in June?
Y'all
signed. Do we sing?
Yes.
Okay, we did. All right, we did. Amen. As you know, I'm on vacation. I'll be on vacation this week. Sister Reverend will be preaching this afternoon today, and she will be teaching Wednesday Bible study. Next Sunday is our Usher's Day, and the Reverend James Earl Garman from the Trinity Baptist Church of Lawrenceville, Pennsylvania, will be our guest preacher. Amen and amen.
What is that,
next Sunday.
Is it in there?
No, it's not. Okay, don't worry about it. It's next Sunday. Usher's Day. Any, Sister Deb, am I forgetting anything? Okay, let's continue in the spirit of worship. We want to turn this portion of the service back into the hands of our worship leader, Chairman Deacon Brian Harris. Isn't he doing a wonderful job, y'all?
Yeah.
Amen. He's doing a wonderful job. We turn it back in the hands of the pulpit.
Amen.
Oh, Sister Reverend.
Yeah. I wanted to come forth really quick about the park because it is next week. We want to gather here about 10:30, especially if you want to catch the van up. simply because we need to get together to get on the van. We need to know who's going to be there. That's also why we have the sign-up sheet. We are going to have a whole lot of games, and I have a whole lot of prizes that will be given out for participation of the games. And if I have enough prizes, I'll even have a raffle also.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
I'm hoping that everybody will come out and have fun.
Amen.
Sister Wanda had already said that she is going to be moderating and facilitating all the games.
Amen.
So she's going to be the one that's going to oversee who's getting the prizes.
Amen.
All right? Does that sound good to everybody?
Amen.
Does everybody want to have fun next Saturday?
Amen.
We are expected to have a lot of food, some ribs, some chicken, some boneless chicken wings, some hot dogs, some hamburgers, some baked beans, green beans, some pasta salad, chips, cookies, soda, juice, and water.
Amen.
Amen. Does that sound like it is a picnic starting to happen?
Amen.
Now all we need is for you guys to show up.
Amen.
Because we're going to have some fun and fellowship with God.
Amen.
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 If you plan to drive out on your own, the park is called Richland, or the park shelter is Richland, and the North Park, and it's at the corner of Inglemar and Babcock Boulevard. It's very easy to find.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Sister Reverend, in terms of Alabama Park, is there a different fee for kids 3 and under, or is everything?
The fees are a flat fee. They have not changed.
Okay.
If you are 2 years old, or 1 year old, or just a few months old, you're free.
2 and under.
Right.
Okay.
But if you are 3 years old or older, it's all the same fee.
Okay, $33.
$33, plus we have a $3 add-on for the pavilion.
Okay.
So it's $36, but you get to have fun in all parks. You get to have fun in all of the soak zone. There's a walking park. There's rides. It is a vast park, and I still haven't gotten to every one of it. And I've been going since my daughter's been 5. So enjoy. Have fun. Come out. We don't want to just come out on Sunday. We want to come out and fellowship whenever we can. Amen?
Amen.
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 Thank you.
Amen. Amen. Continue in the spirit of the Lord. It is it's time for the tithes and offerings.
Amen.
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 We should be getting excited about that.
Let's sing in honor and glory. They all belong to you.
Praise the Lord. Brother Troy, we are so glad to have you as a new member of our family.
Yes.
You are a family man.
Yes, he is.
We love you with all of our heart.
Amen.
And in the Baptist Church, it's a tradition that we do what we call extending the right hand of fellowship to the new member. So what we're going to do is we're going to have everyone come around. You can either shake his hand or give him an elbow bump, whatever you feel comfortable with. Make sure it's your right elbow or your right hand. Amen?
Amen.
And we're going to start with this side, sister, with this side, come on down. Then we'll start with the middle. Yes, amen, right here. Amen. What a joy divine meaning on the everlasting arms. What a blessedness. What a peace is mine leaning on the everlasting arms. We are
we asking that you allow them to get to know you like we do.
Yeah, yeah.
We're not to wait till it's too late, Lord.
Yeah, yeah.
Let them bless and praise you and spread your goodwill, Lord,
yeah,
to everyone they meet. These and all things we ask, Lord, in your precious Son, Jesus' name.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. This morning, I think I'm going to talk about something. I want to talk about being saved.
All right.
Mm-hmm. And, you know, some people think there's a lot of things we pay for with money, with different things, gold, sometimes they share gold. But with God, you don't have to go nothing.
Yeah, yeah.
It's free.
Yeah.
So why can't you, when you see your friend, that friend that rolls the ass or whatever, just say hi.
Yeah.
Even though they're rolling their ass, just say hi. Sometimes they just want you to just say hi to them.
Yeah.
Or they need someone just to know that they acknowledge they're there.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, let them know about God. A lot of kids don't know about God.
Yeah.
And you see what the kids are doing.
Yeah.
So we got to set the example, Justin. You got to, you can't be ashamed.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
God wasn't ashamed when he gave Jesus.
Yeah, yeah.
He gave him without a doubt, but there's none of us on earth that would ever make that sacrifice.
Yeah.
So you got to learn, when you grow up, and I've been trying to put in you in bed, I keep going over and going over it, and I want y'all to do it to them when I'm gone. You got to let them know, they don't need nobody but God.
Yeah.
Nobody.
Yeah, yeah.
Only God can help you.
Yeah.
Doing something. Not your friend. Nobody. Mm-hmm. Just call on God and it's done. Remember when you was going through your little incident on the bus?
Yeah.
And what happened? I told you to pray, and what happened? The little boy became your friend, right?
Yeah, yeah.
See how God can move things out of your way?
Yeah, yeah.
So there is a God. Don't let nobody tell you there is not a God. Yes,
right.
There is. And there's not God. There's only one living God.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay? So I'm asking you, just this, let people know about God. Let them know you're not ashamed to spread the word.
Yeah, yeah.
Because you love God.
Yeah.
Look at y'all, my grandkids, and y'all are spoiled. So, you gotta thank God for that.
Yeah, yeah.
You understand me? And stop doing things that we're doing.
Yeah, yeah.
God sees it all, Jay.
Yeah.
And I told you, you might not see him. He don't punish us.
Yeah.
We punish ourselves.
Well.
You gotta take responsibility. What you do.
Well,
you can't say, oh, God did it. No, God didn't do that.
No.
It's the choices you make in life that make your life what it is.
Right. Yeah, that's
yeah,
true.
Yeah. You
understand me? Know who the J is first and be J. Don't try to be nobody else.
Yeah.
Be you.
Be
you. Yeah. Yeah.
Understand me?
That's right.
I thank y'all. God bless. Lord, we just come thanking and praising you.
Yeah.
Allowing the children to get a message today, Lord.
Yeah.
To know that freedom, salvation is free, Lord.
Yeah, yeah.
And I just pray that everyone that's listening to my voice, that you just guide and hold to God's unchanging hand.
Yeah, yeah.
In God's precious Son, Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Lean on me when you're not strong. I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till you're gonna need somebody to lean on me, oh, when you're not strong.
prayer time, y'all.
Yeah, yeah.
It's the overall prayer time. Anybody wants to come up front?
Amen.
Pray, come on up front. Just make sure we keep the 6 feet social distancing.
Yeah, yeah.
Come on up, y'all.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
And then see, the jewelry that you get every morning, like Sister Jessica said. You get that feeling that surpasses everything. It's like a joy, like a comfort. So I'm just asking, pray for all of us.
Yeah.
Oh, heads bowed, eyes closed. Lord, we just come this morning just asking for prayer, Lord.
Yeah.
Lord, you knew the prayers before they was even announced.
Yeah.
Lord, you know us before we knew ourselves.
Yeah.
Lord, I'm just asking that you bless everyone in a special way, Lord.
Whatever.
Lord, keep that joy in Sister Jessica's eyes when she's coming here.
Yeah.
Give her that hunger, that thirst,
yeah,
to want to know you more. Lord, I'm asking that you look over the children.
Please, Lord.
Lord, these children are lost without you.
Yeah.
And I'm asking that we just let them know who we serve and why we serve.
Yeah.
Lord, I'm asking to pray for the government,
yeah,
the president, the vice president, the people over there in Ukraine, Iraq. Lord, just let them know that you know when you're in control, they're not.
Yeah.
That's the problem. They think they're in control and they're not. So, Lord, I'm asking for prayer for that. I'm asking for prayer for Sister Payne's friend's husband.
Yeah.
Lord, strengthen and guide him.
Yeah.
Lord, that only you can do.
Yeah.
You're the doctor, Lord. There is a doctor, but you're the main doctor.
Yeah.
Lord, I'm asking that you pray for pastors, mom and dad,
whatever,
wonderful, serving you, Lord. And that's why I'm on the battlefield. I see people like them who encourage you and keep you going, to make you thirst to know God more.
Yeah.
I asked a prayer for his sister. God strengthen her.
Yeah.
Let her, Lord, come back strong and powerful.
Yeah.
Lord, to serve and do your will.
Yeah.
Lord, I'm asking for prayer for my family.
Yeah.
They are so messed up, Lord. I'm praying.
Whatever.
And I know they know God.
Yeah.
So, and I know what God can do. Look what he did for me. Look what he did for my husband.
Yeah.
I am so proud to see him up here and praying and stepping out on faith.
Yeah.
You know, I tell them now all the time, turn something negative, turn it into positive.
Yeah.
You know, my mom, she always said, you know, turn something negative into positive.
Yeah.
And now that I'm older, I know what she's talking about.
Thank you.
So, Lord, we just come asking you to bless us, Lord, not just only our church, all the church.
Yeah.
Lord, bless that guy who went in there and shot them people in the church.
Yeah.
He didn't know what he was doing, Lord.
Lord,
he was ignorant to your will and your way.
Lord,
I'm asking that you strengthen him, strengthen the people that got shot. But Lord, most of all, let us make them knowledgeable of who you are. Lord, I ask these and all things in your precious Son, Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So glad I'm here. So glad I'm here.
So glad I'm here in Jesus' name.
Oh, glory. So glad I'm here.
So glad I'm here.
So glad I'm here in Jesus' name.
Scripture for today is coming from, everybody stand please.
Amen.
Our scripture for today is coming from 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 15. That's 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 15.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. to shew thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly divided the word of truth.
Amen.
That's your word for today. Father God, guide us in these times where we know that the enemy is busy.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Father God, we pray that you keep us upright.
Yeah.
Stand on your word.
Yeah.
To do your will.
Yeah.
I'm asking Father God to come to this place today.
Yes, Lord.
Guide our very own Reverend Jabita Hall.
Help the Lord.
Through the word.
Yeah.
Where it's understanding to your people.
Yeah.
And get all of your will.
Yes, Lord.
I petition all these prayers to you in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Let's have a B selection from our choir.
Yeah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then after that, we'll hear from the Lord.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Come on, choir. Let's go. Let's get it.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Come on. Let's do it.
Just lift your hands.
Hallelujah for God.
Amen.
Tabernacle, this is something that was personal and our family didn't want to bring it up, but I think that we need all the extra prayers we can get. My granddaughter, who lives in Florida, she was going through domestic violence, and she's fled Florida with her baby, which is two, and we don't know where she's at. And I'm just asking, more prayers would probably help, that God would keep her safe wherever she's at.
But she's safe, God got her.
We don't know where she's at, and I just hope she's in God's hands.
Thank God
you.
Got her.
Thank you.
Amen.
You ain't not meant to read, Jessica. You got the right.
Amen.
Good morning, saints.
Good morning.
Good morning, saints.
Good morning.
I want to say good morning, not to just the saints here in the four walls of this sanctuary, but to the saints that are reaching out to us online.
Amen.
Because we have been trying to be a different church while being the same church.
Yeah.
A church that will speak to and preach to more than what we are trying today.
Yeah.
We're trying to grow.
Yeah.
We're trying to not grow personally as a church, but grow corporately as a church universal.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen.
So I want to say good morning to all that can hear my voice. And I want to thank, first and foremost, God.
Yeah.
Because God had changed everyone. He has changed me from where I used to be.
Right.
Amen. In a religion that would not have me speaking, would not have me preaching, would not have me even doing anything that would affect someone else.
Whatever.
At least for the glory of God. So I want to thank God for that. And I want to thank Pastor for calling me this morning to preach where he could have asked anyone else.
Amen.
Or he could have gone his vacation.
Yeah.
Amen.
So I thank you, Pastor.
Amen.
And I'm praying for Reverend Payne, even as he is not here in the sanctuary, but he is still in our hearts.
Amen. Amen.
And I want to thank Deacon Harris for leading worship services this morning. Very well.
Amen.
Very welcome.
Amen.
And Sister Tina, all my sisters and brothers here in this sanctuary.
Amen.
Because it's impossible to preach to the flock if there's no flock to preach to.
Yeah.
Amen.
But it's not my flock. And y'all might be a little confused. It's not pastor's flock. It's the flock of God.
That's right. Amen. That's right. Amen.
Which is more important.
Yeah.
To belong to God.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
I want to begin with a simple prayer and a simple piece of scripture. And you guys know that I have a hard time with just one piece. But I've just got one little section to read. Heavenly Father, Lord and Savior, you are our guiding light.
Yeah.
You are that tower that is the beacon at the crest of the ocean.
Yeah.
Your light circles around, telling people to watch out for danger, danger, and to go to the left, to go to the right, to stay on the right path. God, thank you for being our lighthouse. Thank you for being that beacon. Thank you for being that cannon, that right ruler that we need when the days are bright and sunny and the nights are dark and long.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, God, for your hand that you have laid upon us. You have said that motion that you love us and you care for us.
Yes.
And you will be there for us.
Yeah.
God, as I bring this word, I ask that you guide my tongue even now. I ask that you guide those that are hearing to have an open ear to receive your word, to grow with your word, and glean a little something. And if anything sounds like it's a repeat, God, let it be a refreshment. God, you are mighty where you sit on your throne. Yet you have bent your ear down to us. You have leaned into us to speak to us, God. Let us hear what you have to say. Let us learn what you want us to say, to know, God. And if there is anything that you want to say in addition, use my mouth, God.
Helpable.
I am just a broken vessel. I have heard people say I am imperfect, but that imperfect means that I'm close to it. God, I am not perfect. I am broken. And I have sin in my life.
Go ahead, mercy.
Just as everybody else has sin in their life.
Yeah.
Some has more than others, but God, it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Because you have made a way for us to
yes.
wash away that sin.
Yeah.
You have made a way for us to cleave to you and to become more like you. We strive for that holiness that you are. Not that we can be holy, but so that we can be close to you. So that we can fellowship with you. So that we can have something so awesome and so good that God, a five-course dinner can't touch it. That fast car on the freeway, that Lamborghini can't touch it. That mansion and that yacht can't touch it. Because God, you're all more and an abundance. Words are not enough to say how we all should and do feel. But it's the condition of our heart. It's the love in our heart. It's that internal feeling that we are trying to strive to get out. That you understand that we love you. We adore you, God. But most importantly, we love, adore, and respect you. We revere you. We honor you, God. Because, God, you are the creator of all heaven and earth. You have made it and said it's good. You are the beginning and the end. And we thank you, God, for allowing us to be in fellowship with you, to be in communion with you, to say that you're not just our God, but you're our friend. We thank you for your son's name. Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
The scripture that I'm going to read is from Joshua. And if we can stand in reverence to God and his holy word, can we turn to that Old Testament book and read the first chapter, verses 7, 8, and 9. And I'm going to read in the NIV version of the Bible. That's the New International Version of the Bible.
What is it?
Joshua 1.
Joshua
1. And if I said New Testament, I apologize. I meant to say Old Testament. The Old Testament. Joshua chapter 1, verses 7, 8, and 9.
Amen.
When you get there, give me a loud, clear amen.
Amen.
Are we ready?
Amen.
In Joshua chapter 1, verses 7, 8, and 9, it reads, "Be strong and very courageous. Be careful to obey all the law my servant Moses gave to you. Do not turn from it to the right or to the left, that you may be successful wherever you may go.
Yeah.
Keep this book of the law always on your lips.
Yeah.
Meditate on it day and night,
yeah,
so that you may be careful to do everything written in it.
Yeah.
Then you may be prosperous and successful.
Lord, help us.
Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous.
Yeah.
Be not afraid.
Yeah.
Do not be discouraged. For the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go.
Amen.
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 You may now be seated. Quite frankly, I could stop right there.
Yeah.
And that'd be it.
Yeah.
Simply because it's the whole point.
Yeah.
In a nutshell. Simple. But I have to elaborate.
All right.
Because do you know who he's talking to? Mm-hmm. Do you know who's talking?
Help us, help us.
Do you have an idea?
Help us.
Somebody that knows the scripture does, but the person that's actually speaking is God.
Yeah, yeah.
And he's talking to Joshua.
Yeah.
Now, if you look at the scripture right before, verse 6, and look at 7 and 9, God said it three times to Joshua. And he was telling him to be strong and courageous.
Yeah, yeah.
To me and you, we see Joshua as a strong leader.
Well.
And I don't mean like the mayor of the city of Pittsburgh. I mean almost like the president of the United States. But wait, not really.
Well,
not
help
really.
Us. Help us.
Not really.
Help us.
Because Joshua was for so many years under the tutelage of Moses.
Yeah, yeah.
And if you know something about Moses, Moses was the man of God.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
He was picked out of Egypt and trained in the desert and then came to God, rebroken and restructured to be a servant, a leader.
Mm-hmm.
And even that, in that leadership, he did not do as much as Joshua did.
All right.
See, Joshua continued what Moses started.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Joshua was the leader of all 12 tribes of Israel.
Yeah.
And just to give you a little head count, and I'm a little off, I'm a little short on this number, that tribe had over 600,000 military men.
Wow.
Not men or women, just men.
Well,
which meant that he was a military leader, not just a spiritual leader, and not just a government leader.
Yeah.
He was doing all three of those.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's just the tip of the iceberg. You gotta multiply that number by two and three more times because each man had a woman.
Yeah, yeah.
Each man had a woman, had a child.
Yeah.
Each man had a woman, a child, and the grandparents.
More than person.
So Joshua was a leader of a mass of people.
Yeah, yeah.
So we're just getting into a little bit of who Joshua is.
All right, make it plain.
Now,
plain.
When we look at him, we see him looking backwards.
Yeah.
But in this scripture, Joshua is looking forward.
All right.
Joshua can't see that he is the leader of 600,000 plus men.
Wow, wow.
Joshua had just finished mourning over the passing of Moses.
Well,
he could not see how strong he was going to be.
Yeah.
But all he could see was that there was a nation of people to command as a general of the army.
Yeah.
And a nation of people that he had to take care of, to have welfare over.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
And he saw that first as a potential heavy burden.
Yeah, yeah.
And even as Joshua was asked with this task to take on this heavy burden, we too look at each other. We look at ourselves and see our own burdens.
Yeah.
It might not have been that big.
Yeah.
But it's just as impactful.
Yeah.
We would want to look at him, at Joshua, and his journey as it is detailed in the Bible.
All right.
Now, the reason is because we want to glean from it some guidance and some counsel.
Help us. Help us.
And there's other accounts, but we want to just pinpoint on this one.
Help us, brother.
We are exactly the same as Joshua right now, as Joshua was then.
All right.
Right now, we only see this moment in time.
All right.
At that time, Joshua only saw this moment in time.
Okay.
So, we understand. We can put ourselves in that position and that place.
Yeah, yeah.
And I want to expound to you for that verse 7, 8, and 9, what the life of Joshua was.
All right.
As a military leader, Joshua came up and battled Jericho. And everybody knows the famous story of Jericho.
Yeah,
because he was told by the commander of God's army to march around Jericho. And on the seventh day, to march around it seven times.
Yeah.
Yell, and it will fall.
Yeah,
and it was given into his hands. But does anybody know the story of Ai?
All right.
The story of Ai actually started with the plight and the battle of Jericho.
Yeah, yeah.
Because at the battle of Jericho, before they stepped out on that battlefield, in chapter 6, verse 17 through 19, Joshua commanded the army. The city and all that is in it is devoted to the Lord.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But keep away from the devoted things.
Yeah.
So that you will not bring about your own destruction by taking any of them away with yourself.
Yeah, yeah.
Otherwise, you will make the camp of Israel, meaning the whole entire army of Israel, liable to destruction and bring trouble on it.
Yeah, yeah.
All the silver and gold and articles of bronze and iron are sacred to the Lord and must go into his treasury.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So you heard it. That was the command.
Yeah, yeah.
That was the point of disobedience.
Help us, help us.
Because everybody obeyed except one person.
Yeah.
And that one person turned the whole battle, the warfare mindset of these people. They were told to do something, they did it, and it changed in the instant when they went up to against Ai.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
A soldier named Achan took some items that were devoted to God.
Yeah, yeah.
A beautiful robe, 200 shekels of silver, and a bar of gold weighing 50 shekels.
Lord have mercy.
A lot of money.
Yeah, yeah.
But because of his thievery, the entire battle at Ai was lost.
Yeah, that's right.
But the battles before, not one man died as an Israelite.
All right.
But 36 men died. 36 men died out of a battle that was only supposed to be 3,000 men of the Israelites.
Yeah, yeah.
That were supposed to take out this little town.
Yeah, yeah.
Because of that, Joshua had fasted, had laid prostrate on the ground, mourning over this loss.
Yeah.
It was so devastating to him. It was devastating to the army because God said that this land was supposed to be ours.
Yeah, yeah.
But something occurred, something changed, and they took Lot, and they asked God, and God revealed who this was because this person wasn't going to show up and say, I did it.
Yeah.
But by the time the trial was over and the judgment was passed, it was passed against Achan.
Yeah.
And once that sentence was fulfilled, the army was back in good standing with God.
Yeah.
The army went up against Ai a second time and prevailed. Ai was completely destroyed. Mm-hmm. That was the will of God.
Yes.
Now, even though Joshua did not sin directly in this, we clearly can see in the story that God values obedience. Joshua had other errors in his judgments. He was not perfect.
That's right.
When they were going up and doing all the battles and clearing lands, and he had agreed to make a treaty with another land, another people that lied and was deceitful. They had brought about with them some donkeys that were tired and older. They had put in their sack bags food that was already moldy. They were only 2 days out. They used the oldest bag they had so that they can trick this massive people into an alliance because they knew that God was going to clear them out.
Yeah.
Now, the purpose of it, the purpose of telling you this is to tell you that Joshua was not perfect. The same as us. We cannot possibly try to be perfect to the will and way of God.
Yeah.
But we can strive.
Yeah.
We succumb to the errors every day.
Yeah.
When we choose the wrong or instant options.
That's right. That's right.
We are no better one person from another. Yeah. This side of town, the other side of town, this side of the earth, the other side of the earth.
Yes.
But God.
But God.
He chose Joshua to lead.
Yeah.
And God has also chosen each and every one of us to lead our lives, to lead our families, and to lead our friends.
Yeah.
Not by lecturing them.
Yeah.
Not by chastising them.
No.
But with a godly example of how to walk right.
Yeah.
How to talk right.
Yeah.
And how to make better decisions. Yeah.
All right. Yes. All right.
But hold on, I'm getting ahead of myself a little bit.
Okay.
For each one of us, God personally calls us into his beautiful, loving flock.
Yeah.
He wants to have fellowship with us.
All right.
He wants to add each one of us to his family as children, not as babies in need of everything, but as new members of a large, loving, growing family.
Mm-hmm.
As father, he wants to guide us in making better decisions.
Yeah.
As father, he wants to teach us to help others that are in need.
Yeah.
As father, he wants to show us how to love one another.
Yeah.
To love all the neighbors.
Yeah.
To
yeah.
love the lost with a brotherly love.
Yeah.
With a sisterly love.
Yeah.
As father, God knows the difficulty in doing these three things.
Yeah. Yeah.
Making better choices, helping others, and loving unconditionally.
Yeah.
Because of this, God has given reassurance in saying, I know the plans I have for you. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Why am I saying this now? Because it is difficult.
Yeah.
And God knows it.
Yeah.
God commanded us to be strong and courageous because the transformation phase
come on now.
Yeah.
Is difficult.
Okay. Yeah.
This promise
mm-hmm.
should be for every single person on earth, but it is specifically for those of us that have received Christ as our Lord and our personal Savior.
Yeah.
Without that, we can't activate that promise.
Yeah.
If we have to connect with God. And this promise comes with the fellowship of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
We have to build the relationship with God. Yes, God is everywhere.
Yeah.
He knows. Mm-hmm. But even as he is omnipresent,
yeah,
he needs you to talk to him.
Yeah.
You need you to talk to him.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
We need to talk to him.
Yeah,
help us. And I need to express this specifically.
Help us.
Not everything needs to be the right way.
All right, amen.
Not everything, every conversation with God needs to be Heavenly Father, Lord, Savior, and through your Son's name,
yeah.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Amen. We just need to just say, God, I need to talk to you.
Yeah, man, yeah.
We need that informal, I just need to talk to you moment.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm going through something.
Yeah.
I need something.
Yeah.
I need clarity.
Yeah.
I need help. I
yeah.
need a Savior, a
yeah.
lawyer, a doctor. I need.
Yeah.
And we must then listen. Because doing all that talking to him without listening to him, it's not going to get us anywhere.
Well.
Because in listening, we hear the right answer.
Yeah, yeah.
And then the right answer starts to click, and then we obey him.
Yeah.
Sometimes that first time, it's hard to obey.
Yeah.
Because it seems strange, like when Joshua was told, day one, just march around Jericho.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Day two, just march around Jericho.
Yeah.
Wait a minute, I'm the general of the army.
Yeah,
march.
Yeah.
It is hard to obey God.
Yeah, yeah.
But as we start to do it, it becomes easier and easier. It becomes more free
yeah.
for us to do it. It becomes natural
yeah.
to obey God.
Yeah.
Every day. Mm-hmm. Just as we routinely eat, we should be able to routinely draw nearer to God.
Yeah.
By reading. That's your first step.
Come on now.
Read the scriptures.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And for those that have difficulty reading the scripture, don't get bent out of shape.
Yeah.
We're in a digital age.
Yeah.
You can listen. The entire Bible, it is on record for everybody to hear. Because
yeah.
what they say is, faith comes by hearing. What? That's not what they say. That's what God says. It's in the Bible.
Yeah.
Faith comes by hearing, and hearing that of the Word of God.
Yeah.
So it is not wrong to listen if you can't read it.
Yeah.
Sometimes the Word just keeps starting. You just end up with reading the first line. You go to the second line. You end up in the first line again. You start reading, and you think you're in the second line. You're back to the first line. You just keep going around and around. Sometimes you just need that push.
Yeah.
And for those that cannot see, they're already taking advantage of this.
Yeah.
They have the ability to hear it. So there is no reason not to hear the Word of God.
Yeah.
But yet, God is saying this morning that we need to get into His Word.
Yeah.
The stronger our relationship is with God,
depends
yeah. on our connection with God.
Yeah.
Our connection will only grow as we read and listen to the Holy Scriptures.
Yeah.
There's a lot of books out there.
Yes.
There's
yeah.
sci-fi,
yeah.
there's horror,
yeah.
there's mystery, there's kids' stories and mysteries. There is a whole lot of books.
Yeah.
That is just fiction. There's nonfiction.
Yeah.
There's a whole lot of books that people
world about politics and how to live life and how to have kids and how to raise and how to fix cars. But they don't fix your life.
They don't
create a relationship that will never end.
Yeah.
They are not solidifying a holy residence in heaven.
Yeah.
You need to get into the Bible.
Help us, help us, help us.
Again, the more we draw close to God, the more we learn about Him.
Yeah.
What He is teaching in the scriptures.
Yeah.
What we need to know. But on the backside, while we are looking to God, there is something creeping up.
Yes.
We are learning about ourselves.
Yeah.
This might hurt a little bit.
Yeah.
We become more acquainted to who we really are.
Uh-huh.
We're not just opening our eyes to who God is.
Yeah.
God is opening our eyes to who we are.
Yeah.
How nice we are. How not nice we are. How we make our judgment calls and they end up being mistakes.
Yeah.
Or just plain out and out mistakes. Or our actions that we thought was going to be good that just didn't make the cut.
Yeah.
God opens us up to see who we really are and how we really behave.
Yeah.
How we really treat others and ourselves.
All right.
I'm going to say it again. How we really treat others and ourselves.
Yeah.
Because if we love others so much that we're giving to them, but we're hurting ourselves, are we really loving ourselves?
Yeah.
Or are we really giving them just a quarter and we love ourselves too much?
All right. Yeah.
God reveals that, who we really are.
Mm-hmm.
But God wants us to change.
Yeah.
That's the purpose of us to read the Bible. To get to know Him, to become more like Him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
As hard as it is, as hard as it is transformative.
Yeah.
God commanded us to be strong and courageous.
Yeah.
Because the transformation phase is challenging to some
and
terrifying to others.
Yeah.
To break away from the comfort of home and regular friends to go to new and different places and meet new and different people and have new and more friends.
All right.
More friends.
All right.
That we can have relational.
Yeah, yeah.
Fellowship with.
Yeah.
God wants us to come out of where we were to something new.
Yeah.
God commanded us to be strong and courageous.
Yeah.
To be careful. To do according to the law, to be transformed by the renewing of our minds so that we may discern what is the will of God.
Yeah, yeah.
What is a good and acceptable and perfect will of God?
Yeah, yeah.
God commanded us to be strong and courageous. Keep this book of the law always on your lips. Meditate on it. Night and day, day and night, so that you may be careful to do everything written in it. All the rules, commands, and statutes might not apply to you right this instant moment or where you are living at this moment.
Mm-hmm.
However, when we come across a new situation and
a
new circumstance and a new opportunity, the Bible has that need of insight already in there.
Yeah.
Built in. God wants us to turn to the Bible daily for guidance and wisdom.
Yeah.
For your specific situation as it changes moment by moment by moment. And then when you cannot find it, seek the counsels of elders and ministers and reverends to provide additional assistance in understanding the scriptures and seeking God's will. Why?
Why?
Because all scripture is God-breathed and used for the teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness,
yeah.
so that the servant of God may thoroughly be equipped for every good work.
Yeah.
There is one last word for me to say, and I want to you to say it with me, and then I will depart and let you meditate on that.
Yeah.
If we can, read together 2 Timothy 2:15. Mm-hmm. Some of us know it by heart. Mm-hmm. Study.
Hey.
To show thyself approved unto God,
yeah.
a workman that he did not be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen and amen. Grace and peace.
Amen.
Glory, glory.
Raise your hand. That's you.
Say it.
Then lastly, Maybe you have a letter stating that you're coming from a church in good standing. You want to transfer your membership here to Tabernacle. If that's you, just raise your hand. Just raise your hand. Amen. You may be seated. You may be seated. Praise God. Praise God. Listen, is everybody saved?
Amen.
Amen. Everybody must be saved. Amen. Amen. And if you're not, we pray that God will give you another opportunity to turn your life over. Amen. Amen. BB, before y'all leave, make sure y'all sat up in the back there, BB and Tori. Make sure y'all sat up. Amen. Praise God. Did she preach?
Amen.
Come on now, did she preach? Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Let's give her a love offering. Let's give her a love offering. Why ask Deacon if you can get the table? I tell you what, Deacon, we don't need the table, man. Just hold the basket. Just hold the basket. Just hold the basket. We don't need the table, Deacon.
No.
Or Deacon. Oh, Deacon hold the basket. Amen. All right. Thank you, Deacon. Didn't the deacon do a good job today?
Yes, he did.
Amen. Yes. Deacon did an excellent job.
Deacon did it,
too. And didn't Sister Tina pray?
Amen.
Amen. Yes. She prayed. Praise God for them.
Pray.
They're my new dynamic duo. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Amen. Yes.
If I'm not mistaken, the pulpit is full now.
Yeah, the pulpit is full now. Amen. Be going to prayer right off the room.
Father God, we pray that all these monies that we get is just a blessing from you. And it provides for Reverend Hall.
Yeah.
Do what she needs to do.
Yeah.
God, your word is the purpose for this.
Yeah.
We thank you. We thank you for our very own Reverend Hall.
Thank you.
Having her preach the word to understand for us. Father God, guide her.
Yeah, how
passionate she is about keep the passion in her.
Please, Lord.
Yes.
And please guide her to know.
Yeah.
The passion is a lot. She definitely can learn from other Christians too.
Yeah, yeah.
Try not to let the passion get in the way.
Yeah.
Of what you can learn from others.
Yeah.
Father God, we thank you for her.
Thank you.
For our congregation.
Thank you.
We thank you for this hour.
Thank you.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
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 Come on, Brother Porter's side, and Sister Wanda's side, and Sister Linda's side. What a mighty God we serve. Best friend. How old was she? 29 years old. From my understanding, she had a kidney transplant, and the organ didn't cooperate with her body. She went into a coma. She had a transplant about 3 weeks ago. She went into a coma about 3 months ago. The transplant was 3 months ago. She went into a coma about 3 days ago, and she passed. And so this has hit Sister Jamona very hard. So we want to pray for the young lady's name is
Krista.
We want to pray for Krista and her family. Does she have any children?
No.
Okay, we want to pray for Krista and her children. We want to lift up our beloved Sister Siobhan, because this was her best friend. Come on up, Mother Payne. Mother Payne, come on up. Come on this way, Mother Payne. Let's lay our hands on Sister Siobhan. Mm-hmm. We want to ask the deacon this way, we'll pray.
Oh, wise and eternal God, our Heavenly Father.
Yeah.
We thank you, O God, for this opportunity.
Yeah.
To pray for our sister.
Yeah.
We know, O God, that you know all things.
Yeah.
We know, O God, that you are able to heal broken hearts.
Yeah.
Wounded spirits.
Yeah.
Weak flesh, O God.
Yeah.
We thank you, O God, that the sister has had her friend for the time that she did have.
Yeah.
And we ask you, O God, that she will now dwell on those days.
Yeah.
And special occasions in which she and her friend are together.
Yeah.
We ask, O God, that you bless the family of the
please, Lord, have mercy.
Young lady who did pass.
Please, Lord.
We ask, O God, that you will give them strength, O God.
Yeah.
We ask, O God, that you will strengthen our sister's mother who's
please,
here.
Lord, please, Lord, please, Lord.
And all the friends and family that's around her, O God.
Yeah.
We ask, O God, that you will bless, keep, and give peace in the late night when we're not with her, O God. Only you, O God, and she knows it.
Yeah.
We pray, O God.
Yeah.
That you would touch her.
Please, Lord.
And right now, God, whatever she needs.
Yeah.
We ask you to strengthen her.
Yeah.
And your will be done.
Yeah.
And as the day goes on, oh God, his special prayers for her and her family and her loved ones.
Yeah.
But we would ask, oh God, that if there be someone else, oh God, in the sanctuary today.
Yeah.
And we don't know that what they're going through.
Yeah.
We pray, oh God, that if the pastor extended the invitation, that we understand that we only have that moment.
Yeah.
It's still not too late to come.
Yeah.
And to say, oh God, I yield.
Yes, Lord.
And oh God, as we leave this place, oh God, on this Father's Day, we ask, oh God, that you would bless the remainder of our day.
Yeah.
That you will keep us all strong and well until we meet again next Sunday.
Yeah.
If it be your holy will.
Yeah.
This prayer and these blessings we ask in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
God bless you all. We're praying for you, God. We're praying for you. Amen. All hearts and minds clear.
Yes.
Amen. Let us stand. God be with you. God be with you. God be with you till we meet again. Oh, God be with you. God.
Know that I have a love for God's word.
Yeah.
I want to make a small remark. Some of us only open the Bible in case of emergency.
Yeah.
Some of us open the Bible and read them only once a week, and that's only maybe on Sunday.
Yeah.
And others once a day.
Yeah.
I want to implore you. I want to challenge you.
Yeah.
I want to encourage you.
Yeah. Yeah.
To read or listen to the Bible morning and evening, just as he says. Meditate on his word night and day.
Day and night. Yeah.
That is not just reading, but listening to God's Holy Scripture.
Yeah, yeah.
And now, may God himself,
the
God of peace, sanctify you through and through.
Yeah.
May your whole spirit, soul, and body be kept blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Sister Payne?
Amen.